These are some wonderful binoculars. We're going to be testing it here in our very beautiful Potomac Overlook Park. Since we are carrying three of or four of these units, I'm not going to go into the park. I just want to see in nature what these guys can do. We've got on the lineup the Athlon Cronus 10x42. This is their UHD model. You've seen an unboxing of this particular unit. It's a beautiful roof prism UHD glass unit. We're going to be putting that up with this, a brand that you've never probably heard of. Konus. This being their 12 by 50 waterproof unit, model number 2347. This is what's known as Konus Rex. This is their top of the line model with the best glass that Konus produces. They have this in both 10 by 42 and 12 by 50, I believe. The magnification is higher, obviously, than our Cronus Athlon, but what we are doing for our purposes is just doing a general, how does it feel and how long can you glass without getting a headache? These two units are roof prism. We're going to go to our unit that's got a different prism system, Poro prism system. Traditional look. My wife loves this unit. This is the Koa. And the reason that my wife loves this unit and my daughter loves this unit is because of the weight, 16 ounces. It's featherweight. Now, you do have a trade-off. This is 8 by 30, 8 magnification, 30 millimeter objective lens. Gonna put that down, and we're gonna go to our high-tech unit that we are using today. This is the Sig Sauer. I was amazed, people, by the weight of this unit when I unboxed it for the first time. It's an incredible weight. This is a 16 by 40 image stabilized set of binoculars. Zulu 6. 16 by 42, rather. I misspoke. 16 by 42 unit. 42 millimeter objective lens. Now, as many of you know, I am not an optics aficionado. What I want is a pair of optics that actually is easy to use and that I can look through for an elongated amount of time without eye fatigue. I wear spectacles, so that in and of itself is a challenge, right? But I wanted to test these units and give you my feedback as to the sight picture, the color, not necessarily the magnification, because that is different between each of these units. But which one will I use? Which one will I take with me to cruises and various other vacations that we take? And which one will be the most portable unit and the most convenient unit for me to use? That's what we are out here testing today. Okay, let's get to our testing. Let's start with the Athlons first. Again, this is their flagship unit, 10x42 Kronos G2. This is their UHD unit, which is their, like I said, flagship. Now, immediately I can tell you, looking through this unit, that the field of view is absolutely immense. This field of view across is absolutely phenomenal. So if you are using these at a sporting event, for instance, if you are in the nosebleed section and you have these Kronos UHD units, the 10x42 Biathlon, you're in very good shape. You can tell what the action is on various levels, deep into the field, and if you happen to be sitting in the middle of the field, you can see from one edge of the field probably to the end. Now, the trouble that I am having with this particular unit is keeping my hand absolutely steady, because I am seeing just a little bit of vibration in my hands, the natural tremor in your hand. And what's not helping it is the fact that this is a little bit on the weighty side. The build quality of this unit is absolutely phenomenal. It's a tank, but that comes at a trade-off, because when you have a tank, you have weight, and that weight has to be kept steady. And not always are you going to have your tripod with you, so getting the best picture, oh, it's an absolutely brilliant color picture with absolute UHD quality sharpness and color rendition. It's phenomenal, phenomenal. From the top of the image to the bottom, it's completely clear. However, I am given a challenge trying to keep it absolutely steady. Keeping this absolutely steady is somewhat of a challenge for me. Okay, let's move to our Kronos unit, their flagship model, the Kronos Rex in 12x50. Also waterproof, build quality is very good, armoring on the entire body, tactile feel, very easy on the hands, very easy to capture some real estate, especially because this is an open bridge model. So it's easy to hold and to view. Now, one would think that this being 12x50, the shaking in my hand would be a little bit more pronounced than the 10x42 Biathlons, but it's not. And the reason that it's not is because there's a vast weight difference between these two units. This Athlon, even though it's 10x42, is significantly heavier than this unit by Kronos, the Kronos Rex 12x50. So I can hold this unit even without bracing my elbows on this table. I can hold this unit about as well as I can the Athlon Kronos unit. Now, the sharpness, I can tell you right now,
The sharpness is excellent, but not as good as the Athlon Cronus unit. The contrast is just a tad bit less than the Cronus unit as well. However, everything is definitely much closer to me because I've got 12 magnification as opposed to 10 magnification, right? So, using these for a longer period of time, for me, wouldn't be a problem. Keeping it steady as the Cronus unit also is definitely not a problem. In fact, I can hold this just a bit steadier than I can the Athlon Cronus unit. Like I said, contrast is not as much as the Cronus, and the sharpness and detail that I can pick up is excellent, but it is not to the level of the Cronus UHD unit by Athlon. But the weight of this unit, oh, that's spectacular. I'm liking this weight. 12 by 50s, Cronus Rex. Now let's move to this unit. The unit that my wife and daughter love, the Koas. Featherweight, people. 16.1 ounces. However, this is their 8x30 unit. 30mm objective lens, which by far, thus far, is the smallest objective lens diameter. And the least power. 8 magnification. But we've got armoring all the way around the unit. We've got a very easy focus wheel with very minimal play in it. Let's take a look. I love this sight picture. Absolutely crisp and clear. Contrast is spectacular, spectacular. Almost edge-to-edge clarity. Not as good as with the Athlons, but I'm having a very easy time availing a very steady sight picture because of the weight of the unit, but also because of the fact that this is poroprism. And poroprism lends itself to a wider unit, obviously, because it's not straight from the eyepiece to the objective lens. It's offset, right? So your eyepiece, your objective lens. This is classic poroprism design. Some people say that this is not modern, meaning that people prefer the more compact nature of roof prism binoculars nowadays. But I don't know about that. Just the traditional ability to hold the unit with much more real estate available, especially if it's a small unit like this, which is, I think, only 4.5 inches from top to bottom, it's a joy, really, for me. Now, if I steady with my elbows on this table, that sight picture is absolutely fabulous. Now, I am giving up magnification. I only have 8 magnification with this particular unit. However, it's a crisp, clear picture And what that does for me is, even though I am not seeing everything as close as I am with, let's say, a 12 by 50 unit, I am seeing it with precision and clarity, which, even though it's a trade-off, I'm willing to make it. I'm willing to make that trade-off just based on the fact that this is just an absolutely brilliant sight picture that I am beholding with this unit. And I'm going to compare it right now with this Cronus unit again, side by side. Let me see what my thoughts are. This Cronus unit is definitely favoring earth tone colors. The browns are coming out vibrant, the greens are coming out vibrant. But again, I'm having trouble keeping it steady. This Koa unit is much more neutral in the way of the colors. So the brown that I am seeing on the trees is what I am seeing with my naked eye. The greens that I am seeing is exactly the same color that I am seeing with my naked eye. There is not a change in the color palette of the sight picture. With this Cronus unit, there's almost like a yellow tinge to it, so that the browns are actually looking more brown in the sight picture. The greens are looking greener through the sight picture. In layman terms, that's what I observe with between these two units. Now, there's a squirrel in my sight picture. Let me just pick that up, pick up that squirrel with both these units. Yeah, I'm having trouble holding this unit steady. The sight picture with the color rendition is just vibrant. It's different, though, than what I am seeing with my naked eye. So keep that in mind, that the colors that you see in the sight picture through these Athlons is not going to be the same as the sight picture of your naked eyes seeing that same view. It's going to be enhanced by these Athlons. Now, let's get to these 6 hours. I was impressed by the weight of these 6 hours. Absolutely magnificent weight. 16 magnification. Absolutely beautiful magnification. I can tell you that having 16 magnification and 42 millimeter objective lens, if I did not have image stabilization, there is no way that I would be able to keep my hands absolutely steady enough to get a clear, unshaking sight picture. Not possible for me. Let's take a look. And there's that same squirrel. Okay, I'm looking at the trees. Absolutely brilliant. Brilliant sight picture. absolutely brilliant sight picture. It's incredible. And since I've got the image stabilization on, even using absolutely no brakes, I'm able to get a clear, vibrant picture. Now, as far as color is concerned, neutral. So the color that I am seeing in the trees and the leaves with my naked eye is the exact same that I am seeing when using this unit. So it's not changing at all the hues that I am seeing with my naked eye. Edge-to-edge clarity is magnificent. 16 magnification, I tell you, it is incredible. Absolutely incredible. But do you need 16 magnification? That's the question. If you're seeing something very, very far away, you're willing to have the natural trade-off of your field of view being somewhat limited, right? With these koas in 8 by 30, 8 magnification, you get an absolutely wide field of view. And the ability to hold the unit very steadily without the use of any electronic stabilization. With the 16 unit, your field of view is naturally smaller. It's still wide, but it is smaller, which means that if you have something moving in front of you and you want to get a hold of that particular object that's in motion, it's going to be a little bit more challenging, particularly if it's closer to you than with a unit with less magnification. But oh my goodness, the ability to get an absolutely brilliant sight picture without any movement in what you are seeing, and the ease that that produces on your eye muscles, you can use this for hours on end without any eye strain. Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant picture. Let's go back to these conuses. I'm liking these conuses because of the magnification, because of the clarity, because of the neutral colors that I'm seeing. Color is not changed at all from what I'm seeing with my naked eye. The 12 magnification is wonderful. The drawback is I personally am unable to hold this completely steady, which means that I am going to have eye strain over time using this. And if I happen to be on a boat, keeping this steady will be difficult. I can tell that just right from the get-go. Okay, let's give these Athlon Cronuses also their hallmark model. Just another go at it. That field of view is absolutely wide. Let me see, let me compare it, this 10 by 42 unit to this 8 by 30 unit as far as field of view is concerned. Okay. The COAs obviously have a wider field of view. That's to be expected. This UHD unit is a wide field of view Cronus unit. However, it's 10 by 42 magnification. So the field of view that I am seeing is wide, definitely, based on comparable 10 by 42 units. But obviously, it's not going to be as wide as this 8 by 30 unit, just because that less magnification is going to naturally produce a wider field of view. I like the Cronus unit. I like the wide field of view for a 10 by 42 unit. I love the sharpness. The color rendition through these lens is a little deeper than what you see with your naked eye. That issue will be relevant to those that are trying to get an accurate color palette. But those that are looking for very high contrast and a color scheme which deepens as you are looking through the unit will definitely appreciate these Athlons. But to me personally, that handshake is something that I must take into account when I'm asking myself which of these four units would I take on a vacation with me. Because obviously, I'm not going to take 2-3 binocular sets with me on vacation. It's just not going to happen. For me, the issue is really whether the COA 8x30s or the 6 hours Zulu 6s in 16x42. And this is a very hard assessment to make. These 6 hours are absolutely brilliant in the sight picture. Absolutely clear. Definitely as clear as the COAs. As clear, I would say, as the Cronuses. But, oh my goodness, that image stabilization feature, it is a game changer, an absolute utter game changer. Well, I must tell you, if I was personally going out on vacation where I didn't know whether I would be in a position where something would be very far away from me, that 8 magnification would just not be enough, I would personally take along with me this Zulu 6 unit. And the reason is because of that image stabilization. If I didn't know what I was going to be using, the environment I was going to be using the optics in, I would want that 16 magnification power with me so that I would not miss something that was too far off in the distance. And if my trade-off is only a somewhat smaller field of view, not somewhat, it's significant. The field of view it's not like you're looking through a straw. It's not like you are limited and you know it, but obviously the field of view is somewhat more abbreviated with these 6 hours than this koa. But the color rendition being neutral for both of these units, the clarity of the sight picture, and the weight issue, this weighs just a tad bit more than these much smaller, less magnification koa units. I would take this one on vacation with me, definitely. If I knew, however, that what I was going to be viewing would be at a distance of, let's say, up to 300 yards or so, these koas in 8x30 are very hard to beat. Because you don't have the issue of having a battery, you don't have the issue of having electronics. You just have a very nice poroprism set of binoculars with you to change your view of the world around you and bring things closer to you so that you can make your observations and have a ball doing it. So there you have it. On a hike in which I know that I'm not going to be seeing something very far in the distance, and I define that as 300 yards, I would definitely take along these koa 8x30s because they're just so easy on the hand, so easy to use, and an absolute pleasure to carry around. If I was, however, going into an environment where I didn't know how far I would be viewing, I would take along these SIGs. Absolutely brilliant sight picture. Image stabilized, which means that your hand, even moving, enormously like mine do, don't produce any shake. I would definitely take these on vacation. And going on vacation to Asheville, North Carolina, within the next 2 weeks, I can tell you, I'm going to be taking along this unit, the 6 hours, for sure. The engineering behind this unit is absolutely breathtakingly beautiful. Thanks for joining me, folks, as we discuss binoculars, talk about issues, and hopefully you pick up something about what the differences are between these particular units. This isn't a scientific study at all. It's just my love for optics and the ones that I would use, my personal opinion. Give these 6 hours a look. I think that you'll be very happy. And if this is out of your price range and you want a basic, very nice pair of binoculars where the distance that you're going to be viewing things is going to be for, let's say, birding or people watching or something else that is not too far off into the distance, give these KOAs a try. I think that you'll be pleasantly surprised at what KOA has done with this unit. Take care, folks.